Sound design.
All right, so how do I take this cheap microphone that I bought 20 years ago that at this point is probably worth $0 and turn it into a $350 fancy measurement microphone? Or for that matter, how do I take any microphone that I have laying around the house and turn it into a fancy $1,000 measurement microphone, whatever you want to do? It's totally possible. I'm going to show you how to do that today with microphone correction curves. So I'm going to put this back on the microphone stands here and show you how it works. All right, so I know we're still in the shopping and building of our audio analyzer phase of this video series, so I'm not going to go through all the steps of how to take a measurement and how to do the difference of curves calculator and how to set up microphone correction curves. I just want to do this demo for you to prove to you that you don't need a really fancy microphone to get started, okay? So I'm going to turn on the signal generator and we're going to see two different measurements. In orange here, we're going to see my $0 20-year-old microphone, the Audio Technica MB3000L. And in red here, we're going to see the iSimCon EMX7150. And again, this is not really the way you want to set this up. I have this set up to look good for video so that you can see I have a speaker here and two microphones and they're going to make a comparison. In the future, I'll do another video where I actually go step by step through this entire process because you want to be away from any reflections that could influence the measurement. You want the microphones to actually be a little bit closer, signal to noise ratio, things like that. This is just a demo. So just keep that in mind. I will put a link to the calculators that I use in this demo, though, below this video so that you can try it out for yourself if you want. So let's take a live measurement and see what these would look like before any microphone correction curves. All right, here's a live measurement. Pretty different, right? Down here in the bottom, I mean, there's these lines here are every 6 dB, right? So we can see a lot of detail here. Down here in the bottom, we're 12 dB off. Now what we can do is insert a microphone correction curve so that it gets the same data, but then the microphone correction curve says, hey, you know what? Don't put in minus 12. Don't show minus 12. Show zero. Show whatever this is showing. Show the difference here. And so I'm going to turn the measurement back on and put the microphone correction curve in so you can see what I'm talking about. Look at that. Pretty cool, right? That's almost the exact same data now. And it would probably be even better if I was doing this under the right circumstances and not talking and things like that. Now, how did I do this? Pretty easy process. I'll just take you through it real quick. So I would save both of these traces. I would copy them both to ASCII. I would put them into this calculator over here that I, again, I'll put a link to under this video from Mia Krieg Schreiber. That's going to create the microphone correction curve for me that I'm just going to export as a text document. It's as simple as that. And then import microphone correction curve back into my audio analyzer and then put on the correct input. So as I mentioned in a future video, I'll take you step by step through this process in Smart and Sat Live. But for now, I just want to give you a demo here to show you that you don't need an expensive microphone. You can get started for free right now with whatever microphone you have around the house. And it flat doesn't really matter, but if you want to go ahead and create your own microphone correction curve, maybe you can get a friend's mic or you can go to some rental company nearby that has a more expensive mic, ask them to let you use it for a little bit, and you can create your own microphone correction curve here so you can start seeing more flat data or more data characteristic of a more expensive microphone if you want to. Okay, so this is pretty much the end of the microphone shopping section of the videos, and in the next video we're going to get into which audio interface is best. So I'll see you there. sound design. Live.